Getty thief Philippines could become ISIS next caliphate, officials warn after ISIS lost Raqqa, the self-styled capital of its caliphate in eastern Syria, to Kurdish and Sunni Arab forces in October last year. There have been many indications that ISIS, or ISIS-inspired entities, are looking to renew their armed insurgency in the Philippines. As ISIS is driven out of its caliphate in Iraq and Syria, it has emerged that the foreign fighters are arriving in the Philippines with the aim of attacking Filipino towns and recruiting fighters. Philippines military officials warned that the terrorist group had put together a small force of around 200 fighters in Mindanao, with the intent of establishing its new caliphate in February. The island would then be used as a launch pad for further attacks in the country. Getty foreign fighters are arriving in the Philippines with the aim of attacking and recruiting fighters to support these efforts, and at the request of the government of the Philippines, we have enhanced our comprehensive counterterrorism cooperation that supports the Philippine Security Forces. Colonel Christopher Logan, the U.S. has reportedly spent over $1 billion in foreign assistance to the Philippines over the past 8 years, with $85 million being spent on counterterrorism-related equipment, training and support to local forces. And there are now reportedly 23 armed groups in the Philippines operating under the banner of ISIS Philippines. The U.S. State Department has also recently added ISIS Philippines and 6 other Islamic extremist terror groups to their list of designated terrorists. It is understood that former U.S. President Barack Obama's drone bombing campaign in the Philippines was widely regarded as one of the most effective recruitment tools for groups like ISIS. Getty Philippines military officials warned the terrorist group had gathered 200 fighters in Mindanao on March 10. The U.S. gifted the Philippine military new drones, the Boeing In Situ Scan Eagle WAVs, transferred through a U.S. grant of over $13 million, signaling the continuation of a defense cooperation underway in the U.S.-Philippine alliance. The gifting came around the same time President Rodrigo Duterte announced that he would not allow Filipino troops to be dragged into more U.S. at wars unless the country were to face a direct threat. Around the same time, Mr. Duterte stated that the Philippines had not received anything from the U.S. other than brutality and agony after all these years of sacrifice. Getty, the U.S. has recently added ISIS Philippines to its list of designated terrorists, but according to the Military Times Colonel Christopher Logan, Marine Lieutenant Pentagon spokesman, the U.S.-Philippines relationship is growing stronger as time goes on. He said, to support these efforts, and at the request of the government of the Philippines, we have enhanced our comprehensive counterterrorism cooperation that supports the Philippine security forces. And last month, a fight broke out between the Armed Forces of the Philippines, AFP, and the Bangsamoro Islamic Freedom Fighters, BIFF, who has allegedly pledged its allegiance to ISIS, reportedly killing at least 44 militants in the process.